Downgrade the warning rather than to look to the issues. But they cannot do so right now because the data is not coming in and they don't really know or calculate how long this power of the tides will continue to hit these regions. So we don't know what's going on at this moment. And at this time, as we speak, there is a possibility that the tides will continue to hit the coastal regions and we need to be on high alert. Yes. If there is information and data, and little by little, if we see that the records and data are subsiding from all these tidal stations, then the meteorological agency will be able to make its analysis to downgrade the warnings. But at this moment, they cannot do so. And there's been some aftershocks once again experienced at this moment. And regarding the aftershocks, what is the size and how long would this continue?
Well, the magnitude was 8.8.
And so the aftershock is usually minus 1 or minus 2, closer than that. And that will continue for some time to come. Because it was such a large magnitude, it will be for a long time, and even some of the aftershocks were full-fledged large earthquakes, and we have been seeing the points that are hit by cross. It's the southern part of Fukushima where the aftershocks are hitting. It's within 500 kilometers of the quake hit areas. So it shows the size of the main earthquake. So it is larger than 500 kilometers of the Honshu region. So it means it's quite a large scale.
On TV, we're looking at the image of Sendai City and near Natori. As of 5 p.m., you can see that tsunami waves engulfed. ですけれども、この津波のですね、速さ、そして力というものはどういったものなんでしょうか。
そう、陸上にこう上がった後の津波の速さっていうのは、自動車ぐらいかなと思っているんですけれどもね、まあ、秒速4メートルぐらい、それ以上のスピードがあるように見えますね。
はい、今新しい情報ですけれども、室蘭港で8時6分に1メートル、種子島の熊野というところで8時7分に1メートルの津波を観測しています。また和歌山県串本町では7時53分に90センチ、さらには佐世保港、長崎の佐世保港で7時59分に40センチの津波を観測しました。また高知県の枕崎市では7時53分に30センチの津波を観測したほか、広島港でも瀬戸内海側の広島港でも8時11分に30センチの津波を観測しています。かなり広い範囲で津波が観測されています。では宮城県の栗原市役所の